mostly on the Vampire Diaries. Wa Kenya, hamjambo. Hamjambo tena. Mimi nimerudi hapa kwa sababu ya mambo yenu ya stima na mambo ya maji na mambo ya barabara. Ni kweli si kweli? Mimi nilikuwa nimeweka mpango kwa hii finance bill, lakini hawa wakaleta kizirani, hiyo mpango ikaanguka. Sasa nitazungumza na huyu mjumbe wenu. In another 1 month tutaweka sasa 12.5 billion ili hawa mama mboga na hawa watu makanga na hawa vinyozi na wale wabeba beba na hawa vijana hawa, ili wote waweze kusaidika kutoka kwa muradi ya hii serikali yetu. Ni kweli si kweli? Sijui kama tunaelewana. Hii barabara yenu ya kutoka hapa KICC kuenda mpaka accountability, kuelekea mpaka transparency, hiyo barabara tayari nimeweka 10 billion. Contractor alikuwa ni mkora kidogo, sasa nimeondoa huyo contractor, nitaleta mwingine kwa hii finance bill inakuja. Sasa nimetengeneza serikali ya watu wote, nimetengeneza broad based government ya makabila yote, ili kila mtu katika taifa letu awe na mtu wa kabila yake wa kumtafutia kazi na kuiba mali ya umma. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Nyinyi watu wa hapa KICC mnasemaje? Situendelee na hii mpango? Situfanye hii kazi? Salale. Kweli nyinyi ni watu mmejipanga. Ladies and gentlemen, when I began my journey of seeking accountability and good governance, I never thought I'll be here or even to address you. I was a gentleman in my height of life. I'm 28 years old now, very busy. I had my company, which employs over 75 Kenyans. I had work to do, and a lot of it. I was not idle, but there is a higher calling. In this life, you reach a particular point where you have to do something that is beyond you. When you have to do something where you don't benefit in person, when you do something which is about other people, and it has cost me a lot. As I stand here today, I've had threats to my life. I've had threats to the life of my family. I've had salutes from DCI hung around my home with unmarked vehicles. I've had people try to track my phones, to hack my phones. I've had people searching my IP address when I'm browsing. I've had to change cars. I've had to get out of my house in somebody's boot, the boot of a vehicle. I've had to sacrifice my personal comfort and my personal luxury in the pursuit of a dream. A dream of a better Kenya that provides opportunities for the young people of this country to live, work, marry, and grow. And I'm so sad that that future is being stolen by a criminal enterprise that has taken over our governance and our institutions, belittled the value of ethics, demoralized people of good integrity. They have made a mockery of public funds, pilferage, wastage, corruption. They don't do anything if it doesn't benefit them. They don't do anything if it is not associated with their stomach. So sad that to this extent, they still try to lord over us and call us our children. We have heard you. They listen, but they don't do. They listen, but they don't care. Sadly, you, the people of Kenya, have enabled them. You have participated in the fraud. During election, you sell to them your vote at 50 shillings, at 100 shillings, at 200 shillings. You have provided with them with the ammunition to kill us. We need to change. We need a complete overhaul of our society. We need to restore ethics. We need to restore the value of education. We need to restore the dignity of the African girl. We need to restore the dignity of the African boy. Right now, our girls are selling their nudes on strip chat and on OnlyFans for perverts to watch just because they've lacked opportunities to grow in this country. Parents are selling land, animals. They are selling inherited property to take children to school. For what? For them to come out here and be useless? We have millions of youth, well-educated, but without opportunities. Where do you want them to take their brains? If the Gen Z stop being a problem to the government, they'll be a problem to me and you. You will not walk around town with a phone. You will not have money in your account because they have the IT skills and they have no food. They'll rob you, and it will not be out of choice. It will be because the first instinct of a human being is to stay alive, and they must stay alive. We have a public debt that is odious, borrowed but not to the benefit of the people. We have a debt of 10.4 trillion that cannot be traced to a development project. And we have development projects that are tombstones, abandoned graves, long forgotten, and money that belongs to the public already stolen. I've tried to tour the country. I've gone to 19 counties. I began in Machakos, where I toured the Devki Kinanie Road. Allocated 1.78 billion Kenya shillings. Already certified 456 million for payment. Nothing but dust and desperation. To make it worse, the governor of that county lives on that road. I toured the Olkejuado University, which was launched in 2018. To date, it's like a game park. Grass and nothing but nothing. A multiplication of zero raised to power infinity. In fact, you know, because criminals are leading our country, I expect that money will be stolen. But I don't expect that even the gate that was there on the day of the launch has been stolen. The fence is missing. I went to Ngong Stadium. Millions of money allocated. 50 million already paid to a contractor. Nothing. I went to Murang'a County, Kigumo constituency, Ikumbi Road, launched by none other than our president. On the day of the launch, Kenha paid over 1.4 million shillings to a contractor to set up a tent where the president will be shown, you know, this map, this road will pass here, it will go through this place, alafu itakuja pandei, itapita pandei. Oh, bas. That is public, and I'm not talking about the fuel that was spent on fuel guzzlers by public state officials to go and launch about a project that they never intended to finish. Where is the money for this project? Because by the time a government is launching a project, resources are available. Yes or no? Do you know where our money goes? Someone takes public funds, puts it in a private account, fixed account, to earn interest, and in a money market fund. Shame on them. Shame on them. They have made us beggars at home. We are beggars in our own country, na tuko home. I left Murang'a. I went to Nyandarua County. Captain Ndunyunjeru Road. To date, it has been launched twice. It was launched in 2018, launched in 2023. Will the business be launching of roads? It is the worst road I've ever seen in a very highly agricultural productive area. where people will have taken milk. You know milk is quickly perishable. If you don't take milk quickly to the market, it is spoilt. The road is not there since the day it was launched. Twice. I left Nyandarua. I went to Nakuru, where someone bought goalposts for a public primary school, Masinjeri Primary School, 1 million. Football posts, goalposts, 1 million, Bob. I mean, talk to me like I'm a 2-year-old and tell me if we are not living in a crime scene. This is a crime scene. This country needs to be shut down for renovations. Even if we keep talking about good governance, this country is a criminal enterprise. I went to Uasin Gishu, Kipkaren Dam water treatment plant, allocated 1.182 billion from the African Development Bank. Already, a contractor called Mashiri has been paid 767 million. There's no water. And the residents of Eldoret have been told they are now a city. Yet they have water rationing. There is a time during the week when water has to be shut off just because there is not enough water. And there is a project 7 years ago launched that is supposed to bring 23 million liters per day into Eldoret town. That money has been paid and is nowhere. Then someone says, "Huyo contractor alikuwa ni mkora. Sasa nitaleta mwingine." You know, in the Bible, there is a legend of the talents. What did you do with the ones I gave you before you ask for others? What have they done with our money before they rob our pockets for more money? I went to Elgeyo Marakwet County. In 6 months' time, the stadium in Kamarini, which is historic, will be complete. We are in 2024. It is not complete. Public money has been spent. I went to Nandi, Chesumei, to the Deputy County Commissioner's headquarters. Still not in use to date. I went to Kisumu County, Kabonyo Kanyagual. There is Kabonyo Kanyagual Fisheries and Aquaculture Project. 2 point something billion from Hungary Exim Bank. To date, nothing. Just cows and sheep grazing and children playing in an abandoned tomb. This is not a laughing matter. It should depress you. It should raise your blood pressure to no less than 170. You should be annoyed. You should be disappointed. But you know what? They don't care if you're disappointed. They operate on three principles. Weaponized incompetence, emotional fatigue, and Stockholm syndrome. They weaponize incompetence by doing the bare minimum so that we expect the least. Then, they make sure every day we have one corruption scandal for dinner so that we are emotionally fatigued. Because when you go through pain every day, it reaches a point when you are fatigued with pain. Then from there, they kick in the third strategy, Stockholm syndrome, where now we, the abused, are developing sympathetic feelings towards the abuser. Maybe they are not the problem. But ni mtu wetu. Siwezi ni mtu wetu. Situko kwa serikali. Kudhamaki ni wetu. The kingdom is ours. Hii serikali tuko ndani mia kwa mia. Tuko broad base, sindio? This is a broad base, a bread base government. This is a government of a collusion of politicians in government and opposition to completely annihilate and finish their population. Now I wonder, when we are all dead, are they going to govern over graves? Who will they show off their wealth to? Because you know, wealth is only sweet when you can show it off. So when we are dead, who is the audience? To whom will they show off their 14 million and 17 million watches? To whom? When we are all dead. We must take back our country. This is a call for everyone. This fight is not for the poor. In fact, the rich have more to benefit from this fight. They should join us. They should provide the resources. Don't just abandon the Gen Z who have no money for cash bail. They are the only ones fighting in the streets. They are arrested by police. They can't even afford cash bail. They are wallowing in industrial prison. We have people of means and ability in our country who hate what is going on. They should come and defend their nation. Because when our economy improves, they will do better than they are doing now. They will enjoy their wealth better. If you're running a business, this is a moment for you to remember that we are your customers. And if we don't have money, we will not buy. Therefore, you should care about where we, our customers, are going to get money from. We are having an affordable housing program, which is affordable to no one. May I see by hands how many in this room can afford a bedsitter of 1.7 million in Kirinyaga? So how affordable is the affordable housing? To whom is it being built? I was in Makueni County to see the water stadium, which has been built with public funds. 100 and something million already paid to a contractor. Next to water stadium, before they even finish what they were already doing, they have cleared the bush, they have marked it, they have put the tombstone where the president will come to launch the project. They want to start affordable housing. Next to that affordable housing, there is another affordable housing that was built in the previous government. Incomplete, over 20 flats. 20 flats with units inside them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20 flats. The roof is caving in, the walls are cracking. We paid 1.6 billion for our embassy in London. And we are still paying 60 million shillings per year for rent at our embassy in London. I need to go to Pakistan, to Islamabad, where we've paid over 415 million for the High Commissioner's residence that is non-existent. Just cracked walls. Isn't it disappointing? This is a crime scene. This is economic terrorism. And we are just supposed to sit and watch. I'm 28 now. By the grace of God, if I'm supposed to get to 90, for how long do you expect me to watch this rubbish? It has reached a point when I must sacrifice my personal safety and not care about the consequences and say the truth as it is, unfiltered, without fear, with the hope that Kenyans are behind me, that they'll not abandon me, that they'll stand with me at my hour of need, and if I go missing, they'll stand with my children. Please. Do not be afraid of death. None of us is getting out of this alive. Not even them. We are condemned to die the day we are born. All of us will die. The question is when. And the question is, what did you do with your life? You can live 70 years and do very little. But you can live only 32 years like my late grandfather, Honorable George Morara, and do much. We, the owners of the future of this country, must come out and defend our nation. And the best place to begin is civic education. Without everyone on board, Kenyans, we've lost it. We must find a way to bring everybody on board, rich, middle class, or poor. Employed, unemployed. Entrepreneur, non-entrepreneur. Interested in politics, disinterested. Kikuyu, Kamba, Luo, Luya, Taita, Mijikenda. We need everyone on board. We need a resounding majority to say no. That is the only way we'll bring back our country. Right now, a majority of our country has political illiteracy. They can be hired for 50 bob to shout at rallies and say, tunakushukuru sana, sisi watu wa hapa, kweli bila wewe hatujui tungekuwa wapi. Umetusaidia na umetutetea. Umetuwekea mtu wetu katika serikali. Sasa tuko na imani kwamba mambo itafanyika. Can I ask you something, audience? You saw the net worth of cabinet appointees. Why would a person with a wealth of 2.2 billion want a job that pays 1.4 million per month? Yet, even if he earns a salary every day from now up to 2027, even if we add allowances and say we'll earn 2 million, it is 72 million. What is this incentive? What is this love they have for this country? Wow. Exceptional. They love us so much. They cannot believe we are suffering. They would like to help. They would like to do everything in their possible power to assist us. But no, they don't. They are coming to enrich themselves, to enrich their families, to buy gifts for their girlfriends with our public money. I wish they would invest the money they steal in Kenya by building industries and building houses so that people can have jobs. But they take our money to foreign accounts. They take our money outside the country. We lose. We never gain. Kenyans, you might not be me. You might not have the platform that I have. You might not have the following that I do. You might not be as eloquent as myself. But the little that you do, in the space that you occupy, together, it counts for much. You may have only 100 followers. Okay, you may not even have a social media account. But if you speak to your family, speak to your children, speak to your in-laws, speak to your friends, speak to someone that you meet at the matatu, on a date with your girlfriend, talk about good governance. Spare 5 minutes out of the date to just talk about bad governance and how our country is headed in the wrong direction. Make sure this message reaches everyone, including those who are disenfranchised, in informal settlements, in villages. They've been taught to be obedient to a lie. They are subservient and submissive to a lie. Teach them that corruption affects them. Let them not think that corruption belongs to the TV and the people in Nairobi. Let them know that down in the village, right where they are, there could be a milk cooler 100 meters away that was provided under the small-scale farmers industrialization program that has been stolen right next to their doorstep. Let them know that this road where someone died because they could not reach hospital to deliver on time could be fixed. And as a matter of fact, 1.2 billion was allocated for that road. And someone is enjoying it. There will be no peace. There will be no peace for the wicked. Yeah. There will be no peace in Kenya for the wicked. The wicked shall suffer. They shall not have peace. In their big mansions that they've stolen with our public, but they will not sleep. In those beds that they've imported from abroad, instead of promoting local carpenters, there will be no sleep. They will chase ghosts. They will have insomnia. They will go abroad to be treated and there will be no cure. Nothing can cure incompetence. There is nothing that can cure corruption. There is nothing that can cure bad governance. There is nothing that can cure killers. We have dead comrades. We have dead comrades in morgues with bullets shot by public officers in the name of police who are underpaid. Today I put a tweet on my Twitter account. The government said it has increased the salaries of police officers by 40%. A police officer who was confident enough shared with me his payslip, and is no more than 13%. And in that 13%, there are so many deductions you can even not talk about them. There is even the housing fund. How do you take money from us, build us a house, then again sell it to us? Is an elephant a white elephant? Ladies and gentlemen, there is something you and I can do. Do not be cheated to think that you are hopeless. Do not leave this for the media. Do not leave this to be just a work of the civil society. Do not leave it for the lawyers to read the Constitution. It is shocking that our Bible has been translated to every local language, but our Constitution has not been translated. We need to translate the Constitution to every local language, because even the colonialists that colonized this country, they came lying to us in the name of religion. They have misused the name of our God, this King Saul and his prophets of Baal. They misused the names of our God by telling us that we are God sent. We cannot be questioned because we have been chosen by God. There is God in heaven, but that God is the same one that gave us resources. He's the same God that gave us minerals. We have gold. We have oil. We have chromium. We have uranium that is not to the benefit of the people of Kenya. It is being mined, taken abroad as soil. They say we are taking soil samples for clinical research, for geospatial research. Yet they are taking our gold, and we are getting using to launder the proceeds of crime. Pastors here in Kenya are laundering corruption proceeds. A church owns a beach plot in Diani. A church owns a mall. A church owns a helicopter. On behalf of who? Politicians. We need our country back. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm passionate about the subject of good governance. I could speak on and on, but limited am I with time. Let me leave you with this. Mimi nataka niwaeleze hivi. Na nataka mnisikize vizuri. Kwa hii mpango yetu, sasa tumeweka pesa ingine. In another 6 months, nitazungumuza na huyu mjumbe wenu. We have over 160,000 jobs za mjengo. Real people working. And 5,000 youths on our digital highway. I spoke to the ambassador. They are providing 20.5 billion ya hawa wakulima hawa. Ili hawa wote waweze kusaidika kutoka mpango wetu huu katika serikali yetu hii ambayo tumeleta watu wote pamoja ili tuweze kuwa na maendeleo. Ni kweli si kweli? Salale. Kweli nyinyi watu wa KICC mumejielewa.